Hi, in this video, we'll be taking a look at the new PSP InfiniStrip. InfiniStrip is a zero-latency channel strip plugin featuring a modular architecture, so you can design the channel strip you need for any situation. To begin, InfiniStrip comes in both mono and stereo versions, so when you add the InfiniStrip, you can select the version as needed for your track. InfiniStrip features 9 slots in total, 7 of which are a fixed module type, including some special processors like de-essers and de-humming modules, and 2 insert slots which can be any module you'd like. These can be rearranged in any order, so you can easily create your own custom channel strip. The module types include preamps, filters, dynamics processors like gates and expanders, compressors, EQs, limiters, a master control, and some special modules including de-essing and de-humming tools. InfiniStrip also features 3 different view modes. To access these, you can go to the gear icon in the top right and select between the full, resizable, and the mini view mode. All of the modes are fully functional, and your modules and their settings carry over to every view mode, so you can choose whichever view you prefer in any situation. To add a new module, you can click on the plus infinity icon and then select a module you'd like to add. Otherwise, you can click the name of a module slot to select a module to insert. If you'd like to change a module that's currently in use, you can click on the module name and then select one of the other available modules, or use the up and down arrows to navigate between them quickly. To remove a module, you can click on that module name and select remove. Or you can click and drag on a module until it turns red and then release. InfiniStrip also features a variety of presets that can be accessed with the preset bar at the top, and each module features its own presets as well, which can be accessed with the preset bar at the bottom of each module. Each module can also be soloed or muted with the solo and mute buttons at the bottom of the module window. Muting doesn't mute the output of the InfiniStrip, but instead mutes only that specific module in the chain. Additionally, some modules offer the ability to monitor. This bypasses subsequent modules in the chain and allows you to hear only the signal being processed by the module. This feature makes hunting for frequencies to DS or monitoring the compression signal easy and accessible with only a single click. Some modules also feature an external sidechain function that allows you to feed a sidechain signal into the module from outside the channel strip. Finally, to bypass the entire InfiniStrip, you can click on the power button on the outside of the module rack to the right-hand side. One of my favorite features of InfiniStrip is its parameter matching function. When you change a module to a different module of the same class, the parameters are matched exactly so you don't have to change the settings to compensate. This way, you can instantly try out different modules and hear only the subtle changes in character that it will impart, allowing you to quickly and easily find the best module for that track. Because InfiniStrip is zero latency, you can use InfiniStrip for live productions like broadcasting or podcasting, tracking and monitor mixes, or as a regular mixing tool in your sessions. All modules function with zero latency, so you can harness the full power of InfiniStrip in any session or live use application. And that wraps it up for this video. To try out PSP InfiniStrip for yourself with a free 30-day trial, or get more information, you can head over to PSPaudioware.com.